What is called the agricultural revolution was preceded very possibly by a sexual revolution, a change that gave predominance not to the hunting male, but to the female, attached to her children, guarding and nurturing the young of all sorts, planting seeds and watching over the seedlings, perhaps first in a fertility rite, before the growth and multiplication of seeds suggested a further possibility of enlarging the food crop. Certainly, home and mother are written over every phase of Neolithic agriculture, and not least over the new village centers at last identifiable in the foundations of houses and in graves. It was woman who wielded the digging stick or the hoe, she who tended the garden crops and accomplished those masterpieces of selection and cross-fertilization which turned raw wild species into the prolific and richly nutritious domestic varieties. It was woman who made the first containers, weaving baskets and coiling the first clay pots. In form, the village too is her creation. For whatever else the village might be, it was a collective nest for the care and nurture of the young. Stable village life had an advantage over looser, itinerant forms of association in smaller groups, in that it provided the maximum facilities for fecundity, nutrition, and protection. Women's presence made itself felt in every part of the village, not least in its physical structures with their protective enclosures. Security, receptivity, enclosure, nurture take structural expression in every part of the village, in the houses and the oven, the byre and the bin, the cistern, the storage pit, the granary, and from there pass on to the city, in the wall and the moat, and all inner spaces, from the atrium to the cloister. House and village, eventually the town itself, are women writ large. If this seems a wild psychoanalytic conjecture, the ancient Egyptians stand ready to vouch for the identification. In Egyptian hieroglyphics, house or town may stand as a symbol for mother, as if to confirm the similarity of the individual and the collective nurturing function. In line with this, the more primitive structures, houses, rooms, tombs, are usually round ones, like the original bowl described in Greek myth, which was modeled on Aphrodite's breast. The village, in the midst of its garden plots and fields, formed a new kind of settlement, a permanent association of families and neighbors, of birds and animals, of houses and storage pits and barns, all rooted in the ancestral soil, in which each generation formed the compost for the next. The daily round was centered in food and sex, the sustenance and the reproduction of life. Under women's dominance, the Neolithic period is preeminently one of containers. It is an age of stone and pottery utensils, of vases, jars, vats, cisterns, bins, barns, granaries, houses, not least great collective containers like irrigation ditches and villages. The uniqueness and significance of this contribution has too often been overlooked by modern scholars, who gauge all technical advances in terms of the machine.